not be spritzing my water on here if it weren't sealed, because it would re-wet and soften the clay. All right, so for now, let's get a dry cloth. I'm gonna blend this and hope that my sealer over the transfers are, I did two coats, because normally, you know, you don't want all of this liquid on there. But I've got plenty of layers here, so. Now with this technique, this really softens it, and I'm not going to go back and sand. I've got very clear and obvious brush strokes in here. And I'm just kind of making this up as I go. It's kind of a dry, soft blend. Honestly, I just like to play with the paint. That's all I'm doing. Play a little bit more, and then we're going to wipe back here, here, and here. Dry brush. So I am just going to, I'd hold my breath. We can always paint over it. And just, I just want to show, like, geez, I wish I had picked the pictures in front of me so I knew exactly where these are, because I don't want the white to show. I just want my transfers under here to show. Still not sure of this, but it just seemed like a good idea. Can you see that? There's a little yellow in there. All right, let's find this one. That is, looks like part of my base coat, so that's not what I want. I'm gonna have to paint over that. Here it is. I posted the pictures on my Facebook page, but I didn't leave myself out a picture to find exactly where this was. Now, I don't want them to look like polka dots, so we're gonna end up getting like a fine brush and concentrating. All right, I kind of like where this is going. I'm gonna cover that up. I'll go back and blend a little more after. And this. Let's work on this one a little bit. I think this was a pretty small flower right here. All right, I am just gonna have to work around how I am going to show the flowers.
Hi, I'm Michelle at Serendipity House in New Hampshire. I hope you find this tutorial helpful, and you can find all of the products on my website at serendipity.house. Thank you.